Hello and Namaste. In continuation with the complex numbers, we'll be going ahead with the applications of de Moivre's theorem, wherein we'll be dealing with the expansion of trigonometric functions. So expansion of trigonometric functions in terms of the algebraic, like x plus 1 by x or x minus 1 by x kind of questions. Similarly, the sine n theta or cos of n theta, sine to the power n theta, cos to the power n theta kind of questions will be dealing with this applications. So this is the type 1. So part 1 is contained the type 1, wherein expansion of sine to the power n theta, cos to the power n theta in the powers of sine theta and cos of theta, where n is the positive set, or you can say the positive integers. Let x is cos of theta plus I sine theta, which is equals to e to the power I theta. 1 by x gives us e to the power minus I theta. For the detail of all these complex numbers, so now I'm not spending time for the details of this particular thing. Please follow the I button for the previous session of complex numbers, wherein I have explained everything in detail of the complex numbers. Okay, so x plus 1 by x gives you 2 times cos of theta. Similarly, x minus 1 by x is 2y sine of theta. And cos to the power n theta would give us 1 upon 2 to the power n, x plus 1 by x to the power n. So what we have done it for this particular equality, we have just taken to the power n both the sides, and you will get this particular equation. Similarly, the same thing would happen here, and we'll be getting in the powers of sine. So sine n theta is equals to 1 upon 2y to the power n, x minus 1 by x to the power n. Again, same thing as we have done it for x plus 1 by x. Similarly, if we are taking the power n and power n over here of this complex number, so we are going to get something like this, which is x to the power n is equals to e to the power I n theta. Now, this is we are following it because of the de Moivre's theorem. We are following this up because of the de Moivre's theorem. Similarly, 1 upon x to the power n is cos of theta minus I times sine of theta to the power n, which is e to the power minus I n theta. Again, adding them up, we'll be going to get x to the power n plus 1 upon x to the power n is equals to 2 times cos of n theta. Similarly, x to the power n minus 1 upon x to the power n has 2i sine of n theta. So we can get it both the things, sine to the power n theta, cos to the power n theta. Similarly, we'll be getting here cos of n theta, sine of n theta, so and so on. And yes, this particular the expansion, you can go ahead with the binomial expansion. It's x plus a to the power n, which is equals to x to the power n plus nc1. Actually, it is nc0 here, but nc0 is always equals to 1. That is the reason I have avoided here this nc0 here. But in the binomial expansion, you will be getting here nc0, nc1, nc2, and so on. And if you observe here, in the binomial expansion, the first term power of first term is going to decrease. So x to the power n, x to the power n minus 1, x to the power n minus 2, and so on. Wherein the second term, the power of a would go on increasing. So this is a to the power 0 here. If you observe here, a to the power 0 is giving us 1. Then a to the power 1, a square, a to the power 3, a to the power 4, and so on. And at the end, we'll be having x to the power n, wherein the first term, that is x to the power 0, is present here. So this is what is about the binomial expansion. We'll be using this everywhere whenever we'll be going for this type of expansions. Okay, the first question goes as, prove that cos to the power 6 theta plus sine to the power 6 theta is equals to 1 by 8 times 3 cos of 4 theta plus 5. Now again, the same thing, we are saying that x is equals to cos of theta plus I sine theta, then 1 by x becomes this here. Now cos to the power 6 theta, so now we have to do that, cos to the power 6 theta, sine to the power 6 theta, that means what will we get? We will try to find out this particular cos to the power 6 theta and then sine to the power 6 theta here, then we'll add them up. So now going for this cos to the power 6 theta, so we have seen from the previous slide, 1 by 2 into x plus 1 by x to the power 6, which gives us 1 upon 2 to the power 6, x plus 1 by x to the power 6. Now this binomial expansion would come into the picture. As I have explained you, first term the power will go on reducing. The first term, the power of first term will go on reducing, wherein in the second term, the power of that second term will go on increasing. That is what I have explained you. The same thing will be applicable here. Here is our first term, that is x is the first term. 1 upon x is the second term here in this particular expansion. And again, nc0, nc1, nc2 and so on. Here the value of n is equals to 6. So this is our n here. And the expansion becomes here. Now, before going to that, let me explain you what exactly and how exactly we are going to use the binomial expansion. Now, one thing is you can just go ahead and find out this nc0, nc1, nc2 and so on from the calculator. The other way around it, other way is this, by finding it out this way. So suppose I wanted to have the expansion of a plus b to the power 0, that is nothing but that would give me e to the a plus b to the power 0. It will give us anything to the power 0 would give us 1. So this purpose, they have put these numbers in a red color pen over here. So you can just have that. So this is 1. Next is a plus b the power 1, which is 1a plus 1b. So what we have done, this red color, if you'll observe, this is 1. Second step is 1, 1. The coefficient I'm talking about, I'm not talking about the powers of this. Powers, as I have told you, you can say the variable power will go on decreasing, plus the second would go on increasing. The same thing is happening. If you observe here, this 1, 1, because we have got only two terms, the index, or you can say the power was 1, 2 terms. If the power is 2, then you will be getting 1, 2, 3 terms. So how this 1, 1, 1, so just concentrate on this, these numbers. It's known as a Pascal's triangle. So this is what I've shown you here, is the Pascal's triangle. What is happening? You can just take the reference of this particular thing, but I'm just wanted to explain you the Pascal's triangle here. So 1 plus 1 is giving you here 2. So this addition of these two numbers would give you 2. But the first and the last number is always equals to 1. So it is like 1, 1, 1, 2, 1. Then the next time it is 1 and 1, first and the last term will always be 1, but the next term would be the addition of these two. So if you'll observe your addition of this 1 plus 2 is 3, then 2 plus 1 would come here as 3. Then moving to the next, to the power 4, in the power 4 is here, and if you'll observe your first term and the last term is always 1, so we are putting that number here. Then 1 plus 3 would give us this 4 here, right? Then 3 plus 3 would give us here the 6. 3 plus 1 would give us here 4. So in this way, you need to just build up the Pascal's triangle. Similarly, here also, if you observe, 1 plus 4, 5, 4 plus 6, 10, 6 plus 4, again 10, 5, 4 plus 1 is 5. Now, purpose, you have not put it here, the 6, because I need it here, the value of this n equals to 6. How you can build up? By just understanding this particular first. And so that means what am I building it here? A plus b to the power 6 is equals to first and the last term is 1. Now I'm building up this 1 plus 6. So another number would be same, like as I have told you. So this is 6 here, 5 plus 10, 15, 10 plus 10, 20 here, 10 plus 5, 15, 5 plus 1, 6 here. These are the coefficients we have got it. Now what would happen here, a and b? As I have told you, the power of the first variable will go on decreasing. So power will start from a to the power 6. So a to the power 6, a to the power 5, a to the power 4, a to the power 3, a square, a and a to the power 0, right? Now b would go on increasing. So first it is b to the power 0, that is 1. Here it is plus, because it is a plus b the whole power 6. 6 a to the power 5 b plus, because first was a 1 here, b, then b square, right? Addition sign would be here, plus, sorry, here it would come b square, it is b cube, plus what would be this, a square b to the power 4, and let me just give your small size here, 6a, right? So this is 6a and this is b to the power 4, so it would be b to the power 5 plus last term is 1b to the power 6. 1b to the power 6, it is, let me write down this little down here, 1b to the power 6. So this is what is the binomial expansion, or you can say you can build up the coefficients from the Pascal's triangle. So this is what Let me just go quickly now. The same thing we'll be doing it here. Now we have got the first term as x, second term as 1 by x. So x to the power 6, x to the, so just x to the power 6, x to the power 5, x to the power 4, cube, square, x, 0 here, right? Then the next term is 1, 1 by x, 1 upon x square, 1 upon x cube, 1 upon x to the power 4, 1 upon x to the power 5, 1 upon x to the power 6. In this way, you have to build up this, and if you'll observe here, 1, 6, 15, 20, 15, 6, and 1. So we have built up this x plus 1 by x to the power 6 using the binomial expansion. And then just you have to collect the terms. Now after this, you need to collect. Let me just explain you first question in a very detailed manner. So next terms would not be a problem. So now here, I have to collect the terms x to the power 6 plus 1 by x kind of. So this is the first. Then x to the power 6 is here. Then x to the power 5 into 1 by x would give us x to the power 4 here. X to the power 4. Similarly, you will be getting that 1 upon x to the power 4 from here. So this term you will be collecting together. And then x to the power 4 upon 1 upon x to the power 2 would give us x square. Similarly, that 1 upon x square would be getting, you will be getting from this particular term. So this is one term and this is the another term. So we are just trying to get those terms together. And this 20 x cube, 1 upon x cube will give us only 20 here. And that is what the term here is. So this is what the simplification. Now again, x to the power n plus 1 upon x to the power n is 2 times cos of n theta. Therefore, we are just writing it up because of this n. If you observe this n here and this n here in the angle. So same thing, x to the power 6 cos 6 theta. Similarly, this and this 2 is always there with everything here. So 2 times cos of 4 theta, 2 times cos of 2 theta and so on. After that, you will be getting it 1 upon 2 to the power 5 because 1, this denominator, 1 from the denominator 2, we have taken it inside so that this other 2's would go off from here and will remain here with 1 upon 2 to the power 5 cos of 6 theta plus 6 times cos of 4 theta plus 15 cos of 2 theta plus 10. Now this is all about cos to the power 6 theta. Let me go quickly with this sine to the power 6 theta. The expansion would remain the same. Only the difference would be here. You will be getting, this is first term, this is the second term. If you'll observe here, this is the second term we have considered here. So this particular thing, x plus 1 by x with a negative sign we have considered, and then to the power 6 we have considered here. Then you can say that this is what is happening here. Then 1 upon 2i to the power 6 would give us this. Then just you pause the video, try to get this particular thing, what I have got it here. Then I to the power 6 is nothing but I square to the power 3, just you can see the partition over here of 6, which is nothing but minus of 2. Similarly, we are collecting the terms x to the power 6 plus 1 upon x to the power 6 and so on. We will be getting this term, which is nothing but sine to the power 6 theta. Now, sine to the power 6 theta, again the 1 by 2 will be sending it inside, and therefore we will be getting minus 1 upon 2 to the power 5 and this term. Now here, cos to the power 6 theta plus sine to the power 6 theta, we are just adding them up. 1 upon 2 to the power 5 is outside the bracket and rest of the things would come inside. So if you observe here, cos 6 theta minus cos 6 theta, then here it is 15 cos of 2 theta minus, and then plus 10 would not cancel, even 6, 4. So we'll be getting hit here the required answer which they are expecting us to find out. So 1 upon 2 to the power 5, just by some algebra here, you'll be getting 1 upon 8, 3 times cos of 4 theta plus 5. This is all about the first question. Try to get this question on your own. Pause the video, go back, try to solve it again. Then this type of question in the power, in a series of sines of multiples of theta. Again the same thing, cos theta plus I sine theta, 1 by x is this, then sine to the power 5 theta into cos cube theta. Now sine theta is nothing but 1 upon 2i x minus 1 by x to the power 5. Cos theta is 1 upon 2 x plus 1 by x to the power, so now this is to the power 5 to the power 3, that is the reason we have got it here. Now just we are solving it after what the things we have done it in the previous step. Try to get this, whatever I have got it here in the screen. Similarly, this would, you can just easily check it out with this particular 2 to the power 5 2 to the power 3 would come to 2 to the power 8, and this I to the power 5 would give you, you will get it as I. And the same remaining terms, if you observe here, these terms x minus 1 by x to the power 5, x plus 1 by x to the power 3 would give us here x minus 1 by x, the square would come out, and you'll be getting it x minus. So it's just power 5 has been just divided into 2 into 3. The reason is we have to combine this up. We can combine this x minus 1 by x to the power 3, x plus 1 by x to the power 3 would give us here x square minus 1 by x square to the power 3. This is what this is. We are using the property of a square minus b square is equals to a minus b into a plus b. This is what is the property we have used it here with the cube as well, right? And therefore, this particular thing we can just simplify. So x minus 1 by x to the power 2. So it's just the expansion of a minus b the whole square. This is what we can go ahead with. And then this is a expansion of cube. Again, this is a cube means what? Again, you can go for the binomial expansion if you observe here 1. 3, 3, minus 1. So this is because of it is x a minus b the cube. We have to go for alternate plus or minus sign, and we'll be getting x to the power 6 minus 1 3 times x square plus 3 upon x square minus 1 upon x to the power 6. Then just combining, multiplying them, just we have to multiply both the brackets. After multiplication of both the brackets, we'll be getting 1 upon 2 to the power 8 I x to the power 8 minus 1 upon x to the power 8, and so on. Just try to combine all of them, you'll be getting this. And after that, we are just writing it up from here. X to the power 8 minus 1 upon x to the power 8 is 2i sine of 8 theta. X to the power 6 minus 1 upon x to the power 6 is 2i sine theta. Just go back, try to see the answers, try to see the formula, what we are doing it here. We are just replacing these values here. We are just replacing these values, right? Okay, and therefore we are going to get something like this here. 2, we have taken it inside so that the other 2's would get cancelled from there. And you will remain here with the answer 1 upon 128 sine 8 theta minus 2 times cos of 6 theta minus 2 times sine of 4 theta plus 6 times sine of 2 theta. This is what is the answer. Yes, and this is a self-observation slide wherein 1, 2, 3 questions I have given it to you just to have a practice. If at all any query, please let me know in the comment section so that I can address for those particular issues or particular questions. If at all you like the sessions, please stay connected, stay tuned with this channel. Thank you so much. Happy learning.